1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18, it says, "For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved it is the power of God." And turning your Bibles to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, and we're going to look at verse 20. It says, "Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us, we pray you in Christ's stead be reconciled to God." In that verse 19, it says, "To wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation." We got to remember that the Bible says, God's word says, that we're ambassadors of Christ. We go and preach the reconciliation ministry, and that's what we need to do, is the gospel. And I'm going to share with you what about Amazing Grace Mission, what we do. Amazing Grace Mission was founded in 1983 by Dr. James Gardner, and it was 36 years ago, and with over 1 million professions of faith. And so Dr. Gardner went home to be with the Lord July 8th, 2009, and his son John Gardner is the president of AGM now. Our headquarters is in Dayton, Tennessee, and AGM has been in several states. We're in 5 continents, and we are in 13 countries, and then we're in several other states also. AGM missionaries all over the world meet many lost, backslidden people. We go to fairs and festivals and farm shows, flea markets, all over. And my wife and I, we do 14 fairs a year when they're open. Right now they've been closed, but we do 7 in 6 in Florida, 1 in Mobile, Alabama, and then 7 in, or 6 in Michigan. So we do 14 fairs a year, and that's a busy schedule. So we have countlessly gave out tracts. We can't even count the number, how many tracts that have been passed out by sowing the seed of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our work impacts everyone in the community at public events. We meet the poor, the rich, all ethnic groups we meet. And my wife and I, we do in Orlando, when we do the fair there in Orlando, there is several different ethnic groups that we meet there. As you see, as the slides are being shown, you can see the booth that is set up. Yeah, we got a 10 by 10 booth, and that's where the conversation starts, and I'll share what we do there. But what about the local church? The local church can be has a great opportunity to be a part of AGM. How can you help? You can pray. You can take this ministry and apply it to this church, and go to festivals and go out into your community wherever you can go with it and be able to share the gospel with them. Or you can support us. And we have helped many churches. Ridge Road Baptist Church down in Alabama, Porch Baptist in Alabama. We have helped Heritage Baptist Church in Picayune, Mississippi. We've helped Calvary Baptist Church in Lexington, South Carolina. We've tried to get churches to take this ministry and to take it upon themselves to do that and to share the gospel. What a unique way, and I'll show you what we do. In 2 Timothy 2:2, it says here, "And all things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also." We would love to be able to help you to redo your evangelism. And door knocking is great, but I'm going to tell you, at the fairs we meet hundreds and hundreds of people. Last year at the Jackson County Fair in Jackson, Michigan, we had 137 professions of faith. We have countless numbers that we go through, and you know, we don't make a big emphasis on numbers, but we like to be able to when we do lead people to Christ, you have to have some type of a thermometer of how you're doing in the ministry, okay? And so we've led many to the Lord, and just a short testimony, I was saved in 1983. I was a Catholic, and somebody showed me the plan of salvation at a church, and I got saved. And so my wife Kathy, she was saved April 27th in 1980 at a Baptist church, and we're both retired. We retired in 2014, and we sold everything, and then we went south to Alabama, and we helped down there for a while, and then Amazing Grace Mission was presented to us, and so we right away knew that the Lord wanted us to get involved. So we got involved with Amazing Grace Mission, and we've been with them ever since. And so it's a great, great ministry. So let me just share a little bit. AGM rents the booth, or we get a church that will pay for the booth. Booths are anywhere from $35 all the way up to $2,500. At the state fairs, that's where you'll hit where the booths are that much. We set up, sometimes we're outside, we got to set up a tent, one of those canopy tents. Or sometimes we're inside, and as you see, in the slides here, you'll see we're outside here underneath the canopy tent. That was in Alabama at a festival, and my wife is showing the plan of salvation to a few people right there. But the whole thing is we have a conversation pieces, and what it does is gets the conversation going when people are walking by. This is our trademark tract. It's a smiley face. And we stand in the booth. We don't walk on the aisleways. But what we do is we stand right here and say, may I share this with you? May I share this with you? If they take it, then we can say, hey, can I share this with you right here? I'd like to share this with you. There's three things God cannot do. God cannot lie. That's in Titus 1:2. In hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world began. And then I'll say, isn't that a great verse? Before the world began, God promised eternal life to you. Right. Then I'll say, God cannot change. So he cannot lie, can't change. He will never change that promise. Right. And so, in Malachi 3:6, for I am the Lord, I change not. Then I'll say, and then it's in Spanish too, in case there's Spanish speaking people. Then I'll open up this third door and say, God cannot let anybody into heaven unless they've been born again. That's in John 3:3. Jesus Christ said in John 3:3, and I'll say this, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, said, because you never know who you're talking to.
Right.
Now make sure that I get that in their head. The Son of God said, you have to be born again in order to have eternal life. And I'll say to them, and Kathy, you want to get that banner right there? And then we have that little banner. We'll do the little banner first. The little banner here, and it will say, I'll say, what is the most important question in asking your, what is the most important question in life? And I'll say, it's this, are you 50, 75, 100% sure if you died today, you would go to heaven? And so then see how the conversation, how we got them interested in what is happening, and then we have this banner in the back. And I'm sure that most of you have seen this banner. And you've seen it on the slide. That banner really gets their attention.
Yeah.
They have stopped and they'll say, wow, that's quite a banner. So what it is conversation. And then the question is up there too. Are you 50, 75, 100% sure you died today you would go to heaven? And so this is conversation startup. And then we get to the point where I show them in that booth, like what you saw on the slide, there's two tables back there. And then I'll show them on the back table, this is the Bible, the KJV, we use that only. It's in large print, we only use large print Bibles. Because this, when we invite them to come back, I'll say, listen, wouldn't it be one, I'll say this, you're not sure about going to heaven, you're only 75%. So let me ask you, wouldn't it be wonderful to know today, be
before you leave the center of the festival that you will know 100% sure you're going to heaven when you die, know for sure that you have Christ as your Savior, and know 100% sure that you have that eternal life. And they'll say, I say, see that Bible back there? I love you and care about you so much I brought my Bible so I can sit down with you and show you from God's Word His plan of salvation. Has anybody ever showed you His plan of salvation? Many of them say, I don't know what that is. So what we do is we invite them back and give them the plan of salvation. When they receive Christ as their Savior, we have this booklet that Kathy and I, who are the only amazing Great Commission missionaries, give them this booklet. After salvation, what should I know? What should I do? And what should I do? And there are 10 lessons in it. We offer this to them. Say, please take it home with you. Do the lessons, and you'll grow in Christ. Then we give them this little pamphlet, Now That I Have Believed. We give them the eternal security of the children of God.
They can't lose their salvation. We give them this little birth certificate that they signed.
And then I sign it. I tell them to put it in their Bible. It reminds them of what they did and where they were.
Yeah.
Okay? Then we give them this little social security spiritual card to remind them they can't lose their salvation.
Right.
Put it in their wallet. I had a man take this out, and it was all, I think it was like 25 years old. And he had this in his wallet. Then was the most important thing, we get their information. And then that information, like say we did a fair year, your pastor would get all of these professions of faith, and then he would follow up on them. And then what I do is copy that, send them an email and say, listen, go to my website and go on there and you'll see these lessons, and I add more scripture and teach you what your identity in Jesus Christ is. So then, after you're done doing those lessons, we give you this offer that you can send this in, and then you can go and get more lessons for free to grow with Christ. So Amazing Grace Mission is interested in getting people saved. Number two, discipleship. That is very important. Then we have this little booklet too. This is the John and Roman, and it's in Spanish. And we got it marked where I can show them where it's cross-referenced for English and Spanish to help. So this is all what AGM does, and it's a wonderful, unique way to present the gospel. I'm telling you, we have won hundreds of souls this way. And we're in, like I said, we don't brag about that, but it's all the Lord. And if there's any questions, I'd like to answer them. If you got a question about an Amazing Grace Mission, you saw the slide. It's not rocket science. You're at a fair. You set up a booth. You show them the door. You show them the banner. You ask them the question. You have your Bible. You know how to get the gospel. And that's what it is. See, it is in the key brain. I forgot the name of the fair. Anyways, in Sebring, we're in Sarasota, we're in Orlando, we are in Jacksonville, we're all over the place. And so, as you can see, that's how it's set up. The little tables are in the back, and you get the plan of salvation. Anybody have any questions? Pretty simple, isn't it? Now what it is, you got to do it. You got to put it. Hear, just like when we give the gospel, I call it come with the two after. Hear, understand, believe, and then trust the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Pastor, for letting me share this. I know I was quick at the test. I mean, it's not a hard